How did you get in here?
Through the door.
Who gave you permission to be here?
Nobody.
I am reporting you to the principal.
I'm sorry, sir. I thought it would be all right. I just came in to play the piano, man. I didn't hurt anything.
Oh, so you admit it, huh? I'm really surprised. I mean, most of you people, all you do is lie. You don't give a damn about human values or self-respect. What's your name?
Musical.
Musical. Now, what's your real name, not your gang moniker?
Moniker? What's that?
Doesn't matter. Stand up. Move away from the piano. Just give me a real goddamn name in your grade.
Arturo Emilio Cruz. I'm in the ninth grade. Sir, I would like very much for you to give me piano lessons.
Oh, you want to learn to play the piano, huh? Well, you come to class just like everybody else. I mean, what in the hell makes you think you're so goddamn special? You know, all you kids, you do what you want to do anyhow. Well, I don't have time to give free piano lessons to any little shit that asks me to.
All my classes are filled up with things they make me take.
Well, then take private lessons.
There's no money.
I don't want to hear any excuses. I am sick and tired of you little pieces of shit coming in here and busting up my equipment.
You know, I don't think it's fair for you to shout at me, man. I just came in to play the piano. I haven't heard anything, and I tried to take your class.
There are rules and regulations. If I let anybody come in here anytime they want to, there wouldn't be any instruments left to play on. People have no respect for property or equipment or anything.
You know, all I wanted to do was play. Let's play the piano, man. Where else am I gonna play?
You people, ruin everything. You know that? The next thing you know, you'll be coming in here and painting your gang graffiti on my instruments. Now get the hell out of here! I said get the hell out of here! I'm calling security! Get the hell out of here!
Lousy kid!
Wayne, I don't think it's necessary to have chains on those children.
These kids are out of control. Every time I unchain them, they take off and try to get away. Well, I ain't letting these chains off these kids. It's like trying to catch a room full of cockroaches.
Wayne, I'm ordering you to take the chains off.
I ain't taking these chains off, so forget it.
Wayne, they're not gonna get away.
Yeah, well, you come here and try to keep them under control yourself. I've been with them for a week, so why don't you try it? See, this one's trying to get away now. I'm not taking the chains off of these kids.
Wayne, they won't get away.
I bet you they will if I take the chains off.
No, I don't want to bet. I want you to take the chains off.
Officer Hale, do you expect me or the court to believe that you read the Miranda rights to a 2, 4, and 6-year-old?
Do they have any rights?
Come on now, officer. How did you expect them to understand these rights?
What would you prefer I do? Hold them till they finish school, then read them their rights? I've been a cop 17 years, and I've seen all the hard-nosed lawyers, and I learned my lesson a long time ago that if I catch a poodle pissed urinating on public property, I'll read him his rights.
So what was their reply when you asked them if they understood these rights that you read them?
A 6-year-old gave me the bird.
Has it been offered into evidence, the bird? Could you be a little bit more specific?
Yeah, you know.
Let's take a recess. Mr. McGee, Mr. Scully, I want to see your chambers.
Mine is not the question why, you know what I'm saying? Mine is to work for the county, okay, baby?
So I'm here and I'm being forced to hear this case, which I think is a waste of time.
Look, it's real easy.
Good, I'm glad. Because you know why? You've got 30 seconds and then I'm done with this bullshit.
30 seconds? Come on, Justin, that shit!
20 seconds now.
20 seconds? This is a complex case. We're talking about a major Supreme Court decision here.
I beg your pardon?
Yo, hey, Justin, check it out, baby girl. Hey, look at it. It's real simple, okay? The kid confessed it, all right? Did you kill your parents? Yes, we killed our parents. We set the bed on fire, okay? Get rid of the brats, all right?
10 seconds.
10 seconds? Don't put the pressure on here. All these years of law school I've got to remember. Crying out loud, we have a 2-year-old on trial for murder out there. What are we coming to? A 2-year-old doesn't even understand the Miranda.
Penal code 26.
Shit.
That's Gladys R.
A minor under the age of 14
does not know right from wrong.
Surgery is highly recommended because bleeding, duodenal ulcers...
Now, no joking matter.
No joking matter. That's not what I was going to say, Chelsea. I was going to say that they're potentially fatal. Your condition is eating you up, Chelsea. It's your fault, and you're pissing me off.
Just give me something for the pain, Harry. Sign there.
Mom, why did you trash my records?
Yo trabajo todo el pinche día, ¿eh? Tengo dos trabajos para mantenerte. Y no me haces que me avergüence de ti, ¿eh?
What are you talking about? Why are you ashamed of me?
El profesor de tu escuela me llamó, ¿eh? Y dice... dice que otra vez andas con tus chingaderas.
All I wanted to do was play the piano, Mom.
Ah, sí. No lo hagas así, Arturo.
What way?
¿Cómo lo hacen los mensos?
Those are my records, Mom. I love my records.
Sí. Pero deberías de querer a tu mamá más que a tus discos, Arturo. Arturo, deberías de querer a Jesucristo.
Not slipping a ribbon, but tripping, boy, I'm attacking. What about on me, boy? You best come packing. Your life's in the fast lane, think quick, slow brain. Watch me as they go on stand in the crowd and entertain. Heavy bass, migraine, addicted like cocaine. Rappers, my kingdom, over it, I'll reign. Microphone riveting, I make the needle skip again. Ride a soft jam, notch to make a trip again. Hot like fire, and boy, you can't touch me. Put you in the pan and eat you like lunch. Funny people move with groovy taste, scream and shout. I let the people know what the spice is all about. Turn around and shake the head of a president next to ya. Make up in a spicy D and you see how I do ya. But shout about on me if it's I'll be smacking. What about on me, boy? You best come packing.
Back. It's a smaller than you, vato.
Man, I just wanted to check out the toy. I was gonna give it back, but it just got crazy.
So what? Hey, how would you like me to push you around, huh?
I don't like it.
That's right.
Here.
Okay, take the toy and just get on. Fuck with somebody else.
All right.
Come here, Pepe. Come on, Pepe. Let's go kick it with the homeboys, eh? Don't let that vato fuck with you anymore else. Come on. You interested?
I don't know, Jose. I don't want to end it like Victor.
Yeah. Victor was a down vato, man. Here, Jose, light it up.
What is it?
It's a frio.
What's it, frio?
Just a cigarette. It says something that makes you feel good.
Nah, man.
If you want it, you gotta be a man. Look at you standing back there all alone, un pobrecito. Join the locals and there's always someone to talk to. You never be alone no more, Pepe. You never want to be alone on the streets, Holmes. It's bad. Pepe, I know you a long time, man. I'm trying to help you.
I don't know.
Me, before I join, I don't really care, eh? Whatever happened, happened. Pero ahora, now I got something to care about.
I thought you went to that music store. That's what they call your musical.
Nah. Who cares, eh? Fuck.
Fuck it.
I'm not shitting you, Pepe. You can tell by watching my eyes, Holmes. Cops and liars' eyes are always moving shifty-like because they're not trusting themselves. You see my eyes, Pepe?
Yeah, yes.
Good. Then you can tell I'm not lying. Locos, is it? Nobody fucks with the locals, right?
Right.
Hey, we let you jump in, Holmes. You gotta face pain and say death without being afraid. You afraid, Pepe?
No.
Good, eh?
This baby wants to join the barrio.
Up, Barnes. I like that. You used your head. You did good. That was to see what you're gonna do if you know you're gonna lose or even die. You're a loco forever, ese.
Get out of here, man.
Welcome to the barrio, ese.
Ya estuvo, locos.
Hey, I said, did you hear? They found Snippy.
Oh, shit, I say? Where, Holmes?
That junkie motherfucker. They OD'd on Chiba, Holmes, in his old man's apartment.
Damn.
Now, the only trouble is, that Vato's old man was in Quentin, Holmes. So, Snippy's dead body. It just laid there for 2 weeks, Holmes, in a hot apartment. Now, do you know what happens to a dead body in 2 weeks? The whole fucking thing starts to blow up like a balloon. It gets bigger and bigger until, BAM! It explodes.
Whoa, Snippy blew up?
Snippy, Holmes, he was all over the wall and up on the ceiling.
Snippy's an asshole.
Hey, Musico. One of these days, I say, one of these days, the teacher's gonna pay lots of money to hear you play, Holmes. And he's gonna lie out of his ass and tell everybody how he helped you make it the big time.
I say we make him pay tonight.
Yeah!
Let's go to school, I say.
Órale, vámonos.
This is your job.
Holmes, it shouldn't make school so easy to break into, us.
Who wants to break into a fucking school?
Happy night with a bluebird in every tree. What did you observe?
As I entered the parking lot adjacent to the grass, my headlights illuminated the miner.
And what was the miner doing, Officer Green?
Sitting in the park, mind of all business. That's what I was doing.
Now, at this point, the miner turned towards me, smiled briefly, then turned back towards the victim, and for no apparent reason, fired shots into the victim's back.
What are you talking about for no apparent reason? Man, he was biting on my ankle. I was protecting myself. You don't know what you're talking about.
Let him talk. No? Please continue, Officer Green.
As I exited the vehicle, the miner immediately dropped the weapon, turned back towards me, raised his arms into the air, palms open, and began to laugh.
What you talking about, man? I was helping society, man. I was doing your job, man. What you talking about? You don't know what you're talking
Dude,
about.
Shut up! You're making all this fun. You respect the courtroom, man.
He wasn't nothing but a worthless piece of shit anyway.
All right, Woodrow, you're a smart guy, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm a real smart guy. And if anybody fucks with me, it don't be no fighting either. It's gonna be me popping lead up their ass.
Well, since you're so smart, I wonder if you can help me with a problem I'm having.
Sure, I'm always glad to help the law. Now, I was supposed to be doing with him, but now he's trying to have me arrested. Well, look, the judge doing a striptease.
I'm doing what?
The judge finna do a striptease.
Why don't you take this robe and put it on and sit up
you
there?
You may put it on. What you talking
about? Put it on!
Here come the judge. I wish the hall boys could see me now.
This is a circus, Your Honor. I more than anyone can appreciate your sense of humor, but this is serious. This is my client, Your Honor. This is the court of law. In all my 7 years, I've never seen this in your courtroom, Your Honor. Never!
Order in the court. One more outburst like that, man. You're locked up for contempt, you little asshole. Now sit down.
This is insane, Your Honor. This is a mockery of justice. I didn't go to 7 years of law school for this.
Please sit down, Counselor. I'm still in control of this.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it, Your Honor.
Sit down!
Hey, chill out, man.
All right, now, Woodrow, let's say you were the judge.
I am the judge. I'm in control of this whole thing. You work for me now, you work for me now, and I get back some.
All right, let's say for now that you're the judge. And that man over there murdered some poor, innocent person in cold blood.
Your Honor, stop this farce right now, Enter. Take control of your own courtroom!
Okay, now, Woodrow, let's say there was a reliable witness. And, in fact, the defendant admitted to the crime. What would you do?
Oh, that's the easy one. See, some people, from the day they're born, they're bad, just like that asshole sitting over there. He don't care nothing about me. I don't care about him either. I wouldn't kill him, because if you kill him, he wouldn't have no kind of feeling about what the crime he committed, how he committed this crime. But if you lock him up for the rest of his life, that'd give him all those days to think about what he did wrong and wish he never did it. So I'll lock him up and let him rot in jail.
Objection, Your Honor, to this testimony. The minor has not even been sworn in as a witness.
All right, Woodrow, you can come sit down.
Come on, ask me more. I'm having fun.
Come down, Woodrow.
Step down.
You step down. All right. Here, man. Here, take your dress.
Submitted, Counselor. The court has read and considered the probation officer's report. The offense of 187 of the Penal Code, murder in the first degree, a felony, maximum term of commitment, 25 years to life. The minor is committed to the California Youth Authority. The court finds that this minor is an extreme danger to society and cannot be rehabilitated in the time allotted by the juvenile court laws. The court strongly suggests that the defendant not be recommended for early parole and that he remains incarcerated for the maximum term of life.
That's justice, Your Honor! That's justice! Wait, make a record! That's justice, Your Honor! 7 years, beautiful, Your Honor!
Shut up!
You gotta lock this man up, Your Honor! Lock him up! Throw the key on him! Way to go, Your Honor! Justice!
All right, Angel. Get up now. My, my, my. It's a pretty doll. And you, my dear, you are a very, very pretty young lady. You know that, don't you? All done. All done, Angel. That wasn't so bad now, was it, huh?
Not bad. Is my baby okay?
Your baby's gonna be just fine. You get dressed now, huh? And I'll wait for you in my office, okay? Okay?
Yeah.
All right. You get dressed now. All right?
How's she doing?
She's using heroin, you know.
Yeah, I know.
It means her... the baby will probably be addicted as well.
Is there anything you can do about it?
No. I'm afraid she'll have to do it herself. I can help the best way I can, but short of locking her up.
Now, I know you know I can do that, but I'm not gonna do that.
Look, the baby's got a chance. It's got a good, strong heartbeat, in spite of the drugs and lack of adequate nutrition. I've got to do a few more tests, though.
Did you tell Angel that?
Yes, I did.
Please. Shit!
Loft.
I'm not here.
Okay, why did you come here?
To get fucked.
That's it?
Yeah,
That's it, huh?
Yeah.
It's not sanitary.
What's not sanitary?
You use my toothbrush. You should leave a toothbrush.
What are you talking about?
I'm not asking you for commitment. I'm not asking you for anything. I'm just asking you to leave a toothbrush.
All right, what's wrong?
I'm not even asking you to marry me. Never ask you. Problem. Fuck it, all right. Forget I ever asked you about this toothbrush.
Hey, that's the problem.
What problem? Now we have a problem? You know we have a problem.
Jimmy, what do you want from me?
I'm trying to tell you I've got other things on my mind. This kid that raped 47 women the first time.
What kid?
Some kid I met in the hall today. 5 years ago when I first saw him, he was 12, now he's 17, tattoos. Looks like a goddamn monster. Didn't recognize him at first. Some kid I used to teach in my class. Yeah. I asked him, why the fuck are you here? And he said...
Whoa. Jimmy, what are you trying to tell me?
I'm trying to tell you that I taught this kid art.
Did you want me to stay?
Well, if you just shut up and listen to it, okay? Just fucking listen to it.
I don't think you have the balls to tell me.
If you had balls, you would live here and not behind the fucking bench. And I'd say to you, come in, sit down, let me talk to you, let me tell you what's on my mind. You get involved with people, Chelsea. You commit. You leave a toothbrush.
My left leg is getting heavier.
My left leg is sinking into the ground.
My left leg is sinking into the ground.
My left leg is sinking into the center of the earth.
My left leg is sinking into the center of the earth.
Now you must no longer repeat my words. Tiffany, I'm going to snap my fingers, and you will not hear me. I will speak, but you will not hear what I'm saying. You will not hear me at all until I snap my fingers a second time. You do not hear me. If you hear me, raise your left hand. Oh, Tiffany, you're so beautiful. I can't believe you actually came into the courtroom. And I know it's not just because you're interested in jurisprudence. No, you like me. And I could be going out with you this Friday night. You could kiss me with your tongue. Tiffany, you're so sexy. I love when you wear stockings to work. The nude ones. Oh, and when you wear your pink nail polish on your toes, when you substituted for McKee and you took your shoe off in court, and you sort of stretched your foot out in the middle of the Mendez case. You were wearing a taffeta skirt that day. I love your legs. Tiffany, you're the sexiest woman in any court of law, and all I want to do is kiss you. And if I want to, then I just can. Oh, my. I don't believe this. Yes? Who's there?
Why is my courtroom locked? Who's in there?
Oh, just a minute.
Nathan, what are you doing in there? Damn it, Nathan, let me in.
Yeah, I'll be right there. Chelsea, I'm in the middle of something. Just a minute. Tiffany, you're waking up now. You can hear me. You will wake up. And you will not remember anything I said to you while you were hypnotized. Chelsea, I'll be right there. Tiffany, lift your right hand. Tiffany, your right hand. Lift it. Tiffany. Oh, God.
doing locking my door?
Was it locked?
Tiffany, what are you doing up there? Why is her arm up in the air?
Oh, well, that's it's an experiment.
Tiffany, why isn't she looking at us?
No, no, she's hypnotized. It's research, Chelsea, for a case. This minor's defense stated that he had been hypnotized and then told to commit B&E while
he
was...
Oh, hypnotizer. Well, get her out of it.
Oh, sure.
Why is her blouse button like that?
I'll fix it.
No, don't bother. Don't bother. Just get her out of it. Tiffany? Tiffany? Are you all right? Can you hear me?
Just give her a second, Chelsea. She'll be as good as new.
Nathan, please do something.
Just a second. It's not in here.
What's not in there?
Where it says how you wake them up.
Oh, Nathan, you could have at least read the whole book.
Oh, shit. You know... Look, Chelsea, it's only common sense. Now watch this. Tiffany. Tiffany. Wake up. You're my lawyer. I appoint you to be my lawyer, Chelsea. That's an order. I'm still the presiding judge around here. You get me out of this before they book me. I don't want any of those pictures of me with little numbers under my face. Chelsea, don't let them lock me up. I'll die. I'm begging you, Chelsea. You're the best lawyer I know. Chelsea, my life is in your hands. I'm a goner, Chelsea, a dead man. Say goodbye to me, Chelsea. Goodbye forever. And at the height of my career. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Chelsea, you're a godsend. Can I ever repay you?
Think of a way, though.
Miss Tiffany?
All I know is that they've calmed her down.
Judge, would you please sign for your personal effects?
Yes.
One wallet containing $623, credit cards, driver's license, one gold judge's badge in leather case, one pocket comb, 37 cents in change, one prophylactic, one used handkerchief, one gold cross pen, one gold watch. How much do judges get paid these days?
That's none of your business.
I'll say, okay, that's it. Except for this.
This is 46,000 volts of legal retribution, dear. You should get one, just in case. Zap a suspect with one of these for free.
I've got this, just in case. A Colt Python 357 Magnum. A real beauty, isn't it, John? Just for sights. A real fine, smooth action hair trigger. Look at the way that underbarrel shroud moves all the way out to the muzzle. Perfectly balanced. Shifts the weight subtly forward in the hand. Look at that grip, pure ivory. That, Judge, is the optimum symbol of police authority. Never misses. Blow a creep's head clean off. Pure firepower. That, Judge Callow, is what I call legal retribution.
Thank you. You should have been there, Chelsea. They threw me into one of those holding tanks with everything from queers to killers, and some, I'm sure, who were both. Unbelievable. You know how we sometimes think our kids are tough? Well, this is what they turn into after they grow up. Animals.
Are you coming?
Judge Walker, come here a second, please. I have a surprise for you. This is Tang Soo Yu.
It's Tang Soo Yu.
Well, I was close. You know, I'm the one who sent him to see Y the first time. He was living on the border of civilization. I guess you might say I'm kind of responsible for all of this.
Are you the photographer?
Yeah.
Funny the way things work out, isn't it? Darn, but it feels good knowing you've helped someone. I told you my father had some money.
Your father had some money.
We've been worried sick, sir. Are you all right?
Oh, yes, thank you, Sebastian. I'm just fine. I had a little trouble, but thank heavens Judge Walker came to my rescue. Hello, children. I'm so sorry I'm late. Lolito, how are you?
Hello, John.
Come on, come on. Hello, PJ. Lionel. That's wonderful. Thank you, Sebastian.
Will there be anything else, Judge?
No, that's quite all right. But please see to it that Manuel takes his insulin and that all the girls floss their teeth. I got chewed out by Dr. Norris.
Very good, sir. Have a good night, now.
You son of a bitch.
Chelsea, please don't tell anyone. It'll ruin my image. Poor Tiffany. I've never hypnotized anyone before. I saw that book this afternoon when I was out at lunch. I didn't think it would work. Who knew? I really screwed up this time. All it was a little squeeze, Chelsea. Just an innocent little squeeze. I hope she'll be all right. I guess I'll visit her tomorrow after my arraignment.
Callum. Did all these kids come through your court?
Yeah, most of them. Some heard about it and wanted in. We have about 5 or 6 regulars, and the others just come and go. I've had as many as 17 kids here at one time. Last year, around Christmas, you should see me in my Santa Claus suit. You know, Chelsea, I've always been able to get anything I ever wanted. But I think the most valuable thing I ever had was my childhood. That's what I want to do for these kids, Chelsea. I want to give them a childhood.
Gone. Early retirement.
I'm Judge Isaac Jackson. I've been transferred here to take over command from Judge Callow. All of you know that I was calendar judge over at South Central. Compared to there, this place is Pussyville. People, I want my position to be clear to all of you. I will not tolerate playing patty cake with the sentencing rules. I'll review all decisions. And if any gang members come into your court, send them up. I demand a hard line. I grew up on the streets of Los Angeles, so I know it's hell. But I made it out. Play semi-pro ball, become a cop, a lawyer, a prosecutor, and a judge. I figure if I can make it, so can they. This judge considers these children to be criminals who have forfeited their right of civil inquiry. Well, if it were my call, I'd strip a couple of these punks on primetime TV and beat their butts till they screamed for mercy. I hope that this attitude reflects itself in your decisions.
anyone go anywhere.
Police. Pepe Flores.
Pepe Flores. Pepe Flores. Flores. All right, Flores. Come on, right there. Up against that fucking board right this minute. Come on, spread them.
It's all yours. Come on, Pepe. Say can be held against you. Refuse those rights.
Go,
Vince. All right, Pepe. You have a right to an attorney, and I think you.
The court has read and considered the probation department's report and the psychological evaluation and enters that as court's exhibit number one. The court disagrees with the probation recommendation and instead orders the minor suitably placed. Now, Titus, I reviewed your evaluation, and I've decided not to send you to the California Youth Authority like the probation department is recommending, because I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt. What I want you to do is I want you to go see that man over there. His name is Mr. Solera, and he's going to arrange to have you transported to your new home. And he's also going to arrange to have you continue with your therapy. And then I'm going to have you come back in 3 months, and we'll see how you're doing. Do you understand that?
Do you mean I don't have to go to jail?
No, you don't have to go to jail. But I don't want you to let me down, Titus.
Thank you, ma'am.
That's it, Titus. Go on. Mr. Solera, I want to personally take Titus over to the new placement. Will you arrange that, please? See me?
Yes. Have a seat.
You're gonna shoot me?
I've just been going over the file on the Titus Green case. Are you fucking deaf or just stupid? I told you that I wanted those monsters put away. You were there, weren't you?
Yes, you know I was there.
You're goddamn right you were there. Your body was there. Ears were there. Where was your goddamn brain? I knew you'd be trouble right from the start. What is it gonna take to make you realize that we're dealing with animals here? Fucking sidewalk psychopaths. I'm assigning you to the Cruz case. Clear murder one. Some old punk named Pepe Flores struck a deal with the DA. He's gonna testify against Cruz and the others as soon as the cops pick him up. They'll go to adult court where we can really deal with them. Open and shut. You screw this up, and I'll have you assigned to animal regulation, presiding over fucking doggy court. Now get the hell out of here! I said that's all.
Talk to me like that again. And don't ever tell me how to run my court. If you had read all of Titus Green's file, you would have seen that his father had raped, sodomized, and had oral copulation with Titus's sister since she was 7 years old. And that he constantly beat Titus and his mother. And that his three-year-old brother drowned in a tub of filthy water while his father was bathing him. Titus probably spent less than 6 months in a school in his entire life. He can't read and he can't write. And he couldn't talk until he was 5 years old. He's a piece of raw meat left to turn moldy, and you want me to lock him up so he can be rehabilitated. Let me tell you something, Judge Know-It-All. I think the kid did the world a favor by killing his father. And he probably saved his sister and his mother. I'm just too sorry he was late for his brother. I think that some good can come out of a kid like Titus given half a chance.
Are you finished?
I've got one more thing to say.
What is it?
I'm sure that there's some Freudian reason you play with that rod of yours so much. Make me better, Harry. I think your pills make me worse.
It's not my pills, Chelsea. It's you. It's your lifestyle. You've got to calm yourself down, Chelsea. You're keeping everything locked up inside of you. Your body is actually eating itself up. One more trauma, and you're going to do yourself in. I promise you. Chelsea. What happened to Angel?
She had a baby.
Poor kid.
Oh, careful, Doc. You'll hit me.
Oh, sir. I already have one. Chelsea. Some advice, baby. Take some advice. Take it easy, baby, huh? Go away somewhere. Someplace for a while. Go away someplace calm and serene.
Innocent babies.
He
Prosecutor has already convicted this child.
It's his name, yeah. Mrs. Glass. Stay, Mrs. Glass. Mrs. Glass, I would appreciate a little less drama and a little more law.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. Sometimes I get carried away.
Well, try and control yourself.
Yes, Your Honor. Now, Peppy, have you ever seen a person that's been shot?
Only on TV.
I'm not talking TV. I'm talking for real.
TV is real.
No, Peppy, TV is not for real. On TV, when people get shot, the bullet usually produces a teeny tiny red dot about this diameter. In real life, bullets don't make neat little holes. They rip and tear.
Object, Your Honor. We're doing this again.
Mrs. Glass.
Yes.
God damn it, man! That's enough! If you don't stop these theatrics right now, I'm going to have you removed from this courtroom. Do you understand?
Excuse me, I have something I want to show you. I am simply trying to convey to this court the cold-bloodedness and inhumanity of this crime.
And I am simply trying to convey that if there's one more outburst like that, Nellie, the district attorney is going to have to find someone else to prosecute this case. Nellie, you know I mean that.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. Perhaps I am too emotional for this case. I have no further questions.
Perhaps you are too emotional. I'd like to call a recess 30 minutes.
This court in recess for 30 minutes?
Va a tener un receso por 30 minutos.
He won't make you think that fool.
You're being released.
He gets your ass on me.
So what you gonna say on court, Ese?
You know you're fucking pissed, that's what I'm gonna say.
You know what? If you're gonna throw a rat to Ese, I'm gonna kill you when you get out.
So what's your bag? And don't tell nobody about this. Especially your mama, Ese. Yeah, fool. We're being a chavala for it. There ain't no chavalas in our hood, Ese.
You better watch your back and don't walk alone at night.
Is it the locals came here?
Yes.
Hey, babe. Did you maybe want to join the gang?
A little.
Did you join the gang that night, Peppy?
Yes.
How?
They jumped me in.
Well, wait a minute. What does that mean, they jumped you in?
I had to fight some of them. They beat me up.
How many of them?
A whole bunch of them.
Oh. Peppy, tell me, were you just a little high on drugs, maybe?
Tiffany!
Thank you.
back there? You trying to tell me you're gonna go back there?
Yes, I am.
Hmm.
Yeah, listen, I understand what happened today was traumatic. But I don't see why. I just don't see why.
You don't see why? You don't see why. I'll tell you why. Because it upsets me, you see, a child lying there dead. Blood all over the place. Especially right before lunch, it kind of ruins my whole day.
It's not funny. It's not funny.
How can you go back there?
It's my job.
It's your job. It's your job. Was it your job when you got shot? Don't you ever quit, Jimmy?
No. Not when there's kids to help, or children.
Their children? These children are killing each other. Do me a favor, Jimmy. If you go back, pack a gun.
Look what happened today because of guns.
Maybe if you had a gun, you wouldn't be a...
I wouldn't be a cripple. Is that what you're saying?
A cripple, yes.
I did. I had a gun.
Why didn't you use it?
I almost did. I had the kid in my sights. I had the gun out. And all I had to do was pull the trigger. He was 11 years old. 11 years old. Seems easy until the moment comes.
Dangerous, Titus. It can kill somebody.
Titus, it can kill you. Now get out of here.
Now you go get out of my sight.
After you get Titus.
You stop that, Titus. Stop that, Titus.
Titus killed him.
Gonna miss you, Your Honor.
No more, Your Honor.
Come on. Come on.
Ready for this one, Judge?
I'm always ready, Brody. This was gonna be easy, sending a punk to adult court. Like playing God, eh, Brody?
If it was up to me, I'd cut his balls off.
Chickadee.
Court will come to order.
This court finds that the minor is unfit and cannot be helped by treatment available in the juvenile court. And it's the court's order that the minor be detained in county jail pending transfer to adult court for trial and sentencing. Anybody have anything for heartburn? I had Mexican food last night.
I've got some Tums.
No. Got any Pepto-Bismol?
What happened next? Is that it?
That's it. I've got some Rolaids, Your Honor.
No. Nobody has any Pepto-Bismol?
I got some Alka-Seltzer.
Oh. Don't believe this. Nobody has any Pepto-Bismol. What kind of courtroom is this?
Madre Santísima, te ofrezco esta oración por mi hijo Pepe, madre mía. Cuídamelo y protégemelo, madre mía. ¡Pepe! ¡Pepe!
Estoy bien.
¡Ay, qué bueno, mijo! ¡Qué bueno! Sí, mijo.
Get up, Holmes! Come on, Holmes!
You're crazy, man.
I'm telling Holmes.
Let's go before that hood comes.
Wow.
I slept sounder than ever I remember to have done in my life. When I awaked, it was just daylight. I attempted to rise, but was not able to stir, for as I happened to lie on my back, I found my arms and legs were strongly fastened on each side to the ground, and my hair, which was long and thick, tied down in the same manner. I likewise felt several slender cords across my body, from my armpits to my thighs. I could only look upward. The sun began to grow hot, and the light offended my eyes. I heard a confused noise about me, but as I lay, could see nothing except the sky. In a little time, I felt something alive moving in my left leg. Advancing gently forward over my breast, it came almost up to my chin. Bending my eyes downward as much as I could, I perceived it to be a human creature, not 6 inches high.
You know how to get to Mulholland Drive?
At 113837 Mulholland. Suspect described as members of the Locos gang. Also call 555-6203 and one occupant. Roger.
Shoot him! Give me the gun! You killed my dog!
Hey! Susan! Pardo, Simpson, Pardo! Oh, hey, put the question down, old boy! Just shoot me, please! Femme, dog!
A little piece of your stomach is gone.
And a few yards of your intestines. Better get my contando, who's counting? At least my favorite parts are still there.
Where's... Where's Pepe?
He's downstairs. He's in the children's ward. I'm gonna keep him here a few days. His mother. He's okay. He's sedated.
Who's the guy who went over the edge?
Hale. I liked him.
Hale.
Brought him in here last night.
Hale?
He didn't make it. I saw his family out in the hall. Two kids.
I'll never go back. Never.
Thank you.
There is bad as you are. Money's tied, nights is over below. These still ecstasy, you'll never knew be one way to get the combat zone. You can stop fast and tight, and if you're tough enough, chances are you can make it on your own. Life won't overdrive, you can learn to survive, living life in the combat zone. Keep your ears to the ground, keep your shoulders to the wind.
Your homies, facts and family. If I'm with it, I'm down.
Well, I guess I'm